You are listening Greet Your Year Starting Podcast. Now streaming Prisoner's Daughter, a podcast audio's originals. Story written by Rajan V. Kokori. Cast and characters of the story are Scott Jameson as narrator, Breonna Thomas as Swati, Anna Rawson as Komal, Michael Robbins as Das, Michael P. Jones as Jailer, Sherwine Thompson as voice for Hema and Grandmother, and my voice for Chandu and Mani. So what are you waiting for? Let's roll it now.
It was a hot summer day during the month of March, 1984. In Thrissur, the Puram festival was taking place. Swati, her mother Komal, and Hema had completed their visit to the exhibition and Devi temple and were about to return to their home near Nilambur. Komal waved down a car. After getting in, she told the driver that they wanted to go to the Shuranur bus stand. Hearing this surprised Swati, who wondered why Komal didn't ask him to take them to the railway station. Swati wanted to go home by train. Now her mother was taking them by bus instead. After they were dropped off at the bus stand, they boarded a private bus that was headed toward Shuranur. As the conductor neared Komal, she extended her hand, gave money to the conductor, and said, "Vior Jail." The conductor was taken aback by her request. Swati studied the expression on her mother's face. Komal took a white kerchief out of her handbag and kissed it. It had a design of 11 rose flowers on it. Swati had seen that kerchief before, but she had no idea that her mother hand-stitched each of those 11 rose flowers herself. They got off the bus and headed towards the jail door, where they saw a kiosk serving meals prepared by the inmates. Komal went out and bought a pack of chapatis. Hema decided to break her silence.
"Are you buying these chapatis thinking that Mani might have cooked them?"
"Shh! Swati will hear me."
The inmates of the prison had the job of cooking food items and selling them to the public at the entrance to the jail. Komal reached the inmate who was collecting cash for the chapatis and asked him a question.
"Brother, my husband's name is Daz. He might be a prisoner in this jail. Do you know him?"
"Sister, I do not know Daz. Sorry."
"Can you give this handkerchief to him? If he sees it, he will know that I love him. I've been waiting for his release for the last 11 years.
"Okay, I will try my best. I will try."
Komal took hold of Swati's hand and they walked back to the bus stop. They took the bus back to Shuranur and later a train from Shuranur. Finally reached their home. Swati and Komal live with Komal's mother in Angadipuram, a small village in Kerala. While she was lying on her grandmother's lap, Swati managed to get her to tell the story of her parents. After hearing the story, Swati better understood the reason for their visit to Vior Jail. Swati decided to write a letter to her father even though she was not sure it would ever reach him.
Dear Dad, I'm attempting to send you a letter. I'm not sure if you'll understand. Today is my 11th birthday, and I can't tell you how much I miss you. You left on my 4th birthday, which I vividly recall. It had been the worst day of my life. I still recall the police searching of our home and your arrest in handcuffs. I obliged to put down the letter because someone is approaching from upstairs. Later, I'll write you again soon. Your ever-loving daughter, Swati.
Swati waited for the postman beside the fence. Mani, the village postman, was approaching from afar through the paddy field. As he got closer and closer, Swati could see his umbrella swinging up and down. Swati waved her hand as he grinned at her. When Mani approached her, she summoned all her courage and extended the paper in his direction.
Uncle, can you post this letter? I do not have a cover or stamp.
Where do you want me to send it?
My dad, Das, in Rio Jail Thresher.
Mani reacted with an agonized expression in his eyes.
You mean I will send it to Thesaurus Rio Jail?
Swati nodded and continued.
Yes, Uncle. Uncle, make sure no one knows about this letter, especially my mother. I don't want anyone to know I was writing a letter to my dad.
Mani proceeded toward the local post box, nodding his head. The next day, the letter arrived at the jail, and the jailer handed it over to Das.
Das, you have a letter for the first time.
Oh, thank you, sir. I was wondering when someone would write to me.
Das opened the envelope enthusiastically.
Dear Dad, my mother is innocent. Dad, you misjudged her. When the narrative was told to Auntie Hema, I heard her share of the story. I sent it to you a few days ago, and I hope you received it. I am writing for your release from jail on the 2nd of October. Gandhi Jayanti Day. I am sure God will listen to my prayers one day. You will be released this time. My mind continuously tells me. I'm not sure if I'll be able to post this letter or if it'll reach you.
Tears flowed from Das's eyes as he read the letter.
Oh.
Seeing his plight made the jailer very sad.
Das, what's happened? Why are you crying?
I received a letter from my daughter Swati. She's 11 years old now, and I haven't seen her in 8 years.
I heard you had a fight with your wife and attempted to kill the headmaster, doubting an affair between them. What happened after that horrible day in the school? You look innocent.
Das began to tell the story.
Well, the headmaster was missing, and then the police found an unidentified body. They made up a story about Komo, my wife, having an affair with the headmaster, and that he was murdered by me. And then I was thrown into this jail, and I never got a chance to prove my innocence. Never.
Now you've got a letter from your daughter. It's a good sign. You will get a chance to see them, don't worry, and your records are good.
Oh, yes, sir. Is there anything you can do to help me?
Now I know that you are innocent. I would like to get you included in the list of prisoners who gets released on Gandhi Jayanti Day.
Das felt happy, and was feeling even better while walking back to his cell. A few days passed. It was now early on Sunday morning, and the next day, the 2nd of October, is when Swati would start a long school holiday. Komal was startled awake by the sound of a cuckoo singing outside her window. Every day, a cuckoo visited the papaya tree and sat on a limb to consume a portion of ripened papaya. Komal always made sure no one picked the ripe fruit she purposefully left on the tree for the bird. All of Komal's servants, especially Chendu, were given orders about this. The papaya fruit was a favorite in the house, especially for her teenage daughter Swati. Swati slept beside her on a swinging wooden cot on the first floor of the enormous family home. Komal's elderly mother and her widowed sister slept on the bottom level. All of the residents of the house were ladies, so they had to depend on their male servant, Chendu, for the outside work. Komal tried to wake up Swati, but instead of finding her daughter on the cot, she only felt a pillow covered by a bedsheet.
Swati? Where are you? Are you in the bathroom?
There was no answer. Komal dashed down the wooden stairwell to the ground floor close to the kitchen. Her mother sat near the cow, churning the milk to get the ghee. Komal looked at her mother.
Did you see Swati?
No, I didn't see her since early morning.
Komal wondered, where did this youngster go this early in the morning? Komal screamed loudly.
Chendu! Come here!
Chendu was asleep on the veranda, but jumped up instantly and was in front of them.
What happened, madam?
Swati is missing!
Chendu was unable to tell anything from Komal's expression.
Chendu, Swati is not in her bed. She is nowhere to be found.
Chendu looked toward the gate in front of the house and noticed that the massive wooden door of the gate was slightly ajar. Chendu clearly remembered closing that door before going to bed the previous night.
Madam, the entrance door is slightly open. Swati may have gone to the temple.
Chendu did not wait for Komal to react before he sprinted toward the temple. Once he got there, he looked all around, but he did not see Swati anywhere. Chendu's anxiety grew as he dashed toward the Angadipuram bus stop, which was an asbestos sheet shed. A few more furlongs away was the railway station. As Chendu searched outside, Komal ran upstairs to Swati's study and began searching the entire room immediately. She opened Swati's favorite flower album. Swati had a habit of drying flowers and leaves and pasting them on its pages. Suddenly, a paper fell out of the album. Komal spread out the paper, which had a few lines scribbled in pencil. As she read them, Komal's hand shook, and the letter slipped from her grip.
Dear Dad, Mom revealed that incredible incident occurred only once in her life. It was one of her school days when she was teaching. She was on an excursion tour of the school with youngsters and other employees when you came down for vacation. During the tour, the headmaster was also present. The headmaster used to harass her very often. He had arranged the next room as Mother's class. Once, he asked Mom to stay back in the school after class. The headmaster told Mom that her physical examination must be taken to know about her fitness to submit to the educational department. Oh, he misbehaved with Mom, pretending to take her measurements. Mom hit him in a groan and ran from school. You met her at the school gate. You saw her with loosened hair and an untidy dress. You didn't wait for an explanation from Mother, but went and hit the headmaster with a wooden chair. The headmaster fell unconscious. You had assumed that Mom was having an affair with the master. Dad, my mother is innocent. Please, please pardon me.
Swati must have missed sending this letter, but Komal thought she may have sent others in the past. Komal's tears became uncontrollable and began to pour down her cheeks. It occurred to her that Swati might have gone to meet her father. Not finding Swati at the bus stop, Chandu frantically pedaled his bike to the railway station, which was a few furlongs away and 3 kilometers from where Swati lived. He was greatly relieved when he saw Swati sitting on a bench on the platform.
Swati, how come you left alone without informing anyone at home? Huh? Your mother and grandmother are very much worried.
Don't you know that today is October 2nd? And that my father will be released from prison?
How did you find out?
I heard on the radio yesterday that he will be released on Gandhi Jayanti Day.
How can you be so sure of it?
I have prayed to God. And I am confident that he will arrive on the Sharanir passenger train. Let's stand at the next exit so we don't miss Dad.
At the platform, there was a loud announcement.
In a few minutes, the Sharanir Nilambur passenger train will arrive on platform number 1.
They had already heard the train whistle. After a few minutes, the train arrived. Swati searched the rush of passengers for her father. After a few moments, she noticed an older man with a beard stepping down from the train, wearing a tattered outfit and holding a canvas bag. Swati dashed over to him, grabbed his hand, and spoke to him.
Dad! I've been waiting for you for 8 years.
Oh, Swati. I'm really unclean right now, my sweet daughter. Oh, my clothes are dirty, and I smell so rotten.
Das fondly touched Swati's head without touching her body. Swati hugged him tightly and said,
Dad, you smell like roses for me.
Chandu drove them back to Komal's residence on his bicycle. Swati kept her gaze fixed on Das the entire time.
Dad, have you forgiven my mother?
Oh, Swati, of course I have, my sweetheart.
Chandu accelerated his pedaling to get them back to Komal as quickly as he could. Das felt guilty for doubting Komal all those years, and hoped she would pardon him and accept him wholeheartedly. The end.
This was Prisoner's Daughter, a podcast audio's originals. Hey, I'm eagerly waiting to know your review on this story. Please let us know on our Instagram handle @podcastaudios. If you like Prisoner's Daughter, don't feel shy to share it in your Instagram stories with your friends and family. A big thank you to the full cast of Prisoner's Daughter: actor Scott Jameson, actress Breonna M. Thomas, actress Anna Rossell, voice artist Michael Robbins, actor Michael P. Jones, actress Sherwin Thompson. You can connect with the cast on social media. The links are mentioned in the description of the story. By the way, I'm still waiting for your review about this story, Prisoner's Daughter. I'm still waiting for your review about this story on Instagram @podcastaudios. Thanks for listening. Thank you. Hey guys, I hope you enjoyed this story. If you like this story, if you like the show, please make sure you follow us on Spotify and the platforms you're listening to. Make sure you place a review and ratings so that we are motivated with 100x. Thank you so much. Stay tuned. Stay safe.